Rabbi Mechavim said, Tfilu, one who feels to make the Erev Tavshilin only to the Yomtiv that he's standing, only on Erev Yomtiv that he's standing by, that's when you will feel to make the Erev Tavshilin. And one should not, cannot make the Erev Tavshilin earlier than that. Did the Eved, the Chayim say, did the Eved, if one did make the Erev Tavshilin on Erev Rosh Hashanah, having in mind, so certainly if somebody made the Erev Tavshilin on Erev Yomtiv, on Erev Rosh Hashanah, and didn't have in mind the Erev Sukkis, it just happens to be that they didn't eat it, so it's left over and it's still around, still been in, so when it comes to Erev Sukkis, that's certainly not good. But if he made Erev Tavshilin on Erev Rosh Hashanah, is he keeping to himself that he's going to make it now on Erev Rosh Hashanah for Erev Sukkis and Erev Shemini Atzeres, now he's going to make the Erev Tavshilin. If it's still around before Erev Sukkis, on Erev Sukkis, still around on Sukkis, then it could be used by the Chachila. You shouldn't do so, and Chachila soon is already Erev Yomtiv, and not yet Yomtiv. Let me just eat off the Erev, eat off that egg, eat off that piece of meat, and he'll make a new one. Once it's already Sukkis, though, if he had the Erev Tavshilin, they made it at Erev Rosh Hashanah, and it's already Sukkis, he could be soivach, he could cook on Sukkis using that Erev Tavshilin that had been made on Erev Rosh Hashanah with the Kavanah for Erev, with the Kavanah for Sukkis as well.